James Bay, really nice to speak to you.
Likewise.
You've been away for a while.
I have.
And I feel like, did you need a break? Because for us, it felt like you exploded overnight.
Right, cool. But,
I mean,
that's
assuming
great.
It didn't feel like that for you.
Oh, absolutely. No. It did. But like, the other thing about being away for a while, I feel like you go away for 5 minutes and everybody thinks it's 5 years.
That's true.
It's an interesting one there. I feel like you can only be like gone too long. I was away for a year, and I know that's not a short amount of time.
That actually really isn't that long, but it does feel longer.
And even at this point, 2017 feels like it flew by, and because I was incredibly busy the whole time, I did go on holiday for 10 days,
in the whole year.
Yeah, but I was at home as well. I made this record in London.
Where'd you go on holiday? Where was
that
10 days?
To Grenada in the Caribbean.
Ooh.
There's Grenada and Granada. Granada's Spain. Granada's the Caribbean.
Oh.
I'd never done like a Caribbean holiday thing like that before.
That sounds amazing.
As you can see, I got an amazing tan. Thank you.
Do you tan?
Not at all.
Oh, yeah.
Not for a second. I burn. Like there's no tomorrow. But no, I don't tan.
I know. I'm full wide brim tan.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Wide
Kaftan,
umbrella. Like,
umbrella,
to be honest.
Parasol, everything.
A whole bit.
We don't know the name of your album.
No.
Keeping that very close to your chest.
Yes.
Why this like Star Wars level secrecy with this?
Because you can find out everything all the time these days. You can find out everything. You follow through someone's social media here, there and everywhere, and you can find out everything. So I figure, well, if I just don't tell anyone or say it, then nobody can write it down. And I can hold on to a little bit of mystery, because the album's not going to come out until spring. There's a single coming today. There'll be more of that kind of thing, and then the album. So nearer that time, I'll let people know what it's called.
Have you accidentally slipped it out by like, obviously no one knows, but have you said it? Because if you think about words, it sometimes just comes.
No, you're right. But no, so far so good.
So it's a word that you wouldn't say.
Yeah, I don't think you're going to catch me out. I don't think you're going to catch me out, but we'll see.
So even though for a while, I felt like I saw your face more than like my own mum's.
Okay.
And it's a compliment. You know, it's not a bad thing.
All right.
But I feel like I don't know very much about you. I feel like everyone's very...
That's all right. We've got this now.
Yeah,
that's quite natural.
Yeah. So I wanted to do a bit of a getting to know you.
Sure.
Not very quick fire. These are like...
All right. We'll go a bit deeper.
Originally called The Man Beneath the Hat, but you've got rid of the hat now. So I'm going to...
Well, I'm still the man.
You're still the man.
Like, just without the hat.
What makes you irrationally angry?
What makes me irrationally angry?
Yeah, like a split second of burning rage.
Wow. I mean, they're pretty heavy topics, to be honest. I don't want to go too deep. I don't want to get too like righteous.
You're going to get really politically anxious.
Like, well, yeah. I mean, you got to watch out, because that's the kind of stuff that gets me sort of pissed off.
Okay.
Do you want a silly answer?
And like, so mine is like people stepping on the back of my shoe.
No, I'm cool with that. I guess when you're walking down a hallway,
yeah,
and there's a door, and somebody's ahead of you, and they open the door, and you're like 3 steps behind. And they let it swing back so that as soon as you arrive at the door, it's like slamming in your face. That's not cool.
It's not very polite, is it?
I like to try. I try and hold doors open myself.
Doing that awkward thing of like holding a million doors.
I
don't know how to say that.
I'd wait for someone to come to the door and just hold the door. I'd have to be in a pretty serious rush not to. I don't think it gets me irrationally angry, but that's my answer.
What's the ultimate hangover food?
Cheese on toast. I reckon.
So good. That's just like the ultimate food always.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
If you could change one thing about yourself, what would it be?
Good question.
I'm not meaning to get deep here, but I feel like...
No, because I feel like I'm all right. If I could change one thing about myself, what would it be? That I didn't get so irrationally angry when people like just let a door swing in my face. Yeah.
What was the last film you saw and what did you think of it?
I saw The Revenant, which I know is kind of an old film now, but I saw The Revenant the other night. And I know that when it came out, which is about 2 years ago now, 3 years ago, when it came out and then Leonardo DiCaprio won an Oscar for it, and he kind of finally won an Oscar because he's obviously played so many incredible roles, there was all this like talk of, oh, he shouldn't have got it for that one. He didn't really deserve it. He rolled around in the woods for 2.5 hours. He's amazing in that film. So he absolutely deserved it.
He says a lot by grunting in that film.
Well, I think that's all you can do when you've basically been like torn to pieces and I'm not giving anything away there.
He also lived in like a buffalo for a while. Like
that was actually, pretty intense.
Yeah, he did that.
That was,
he deserves it for that.
So yeah.
Do you ever sing karaoke? And if you do, what's your go-to song?
It was only about 2 years ago that I did karaoke for the first time. And I've been desperate to do it and I'd never done karaoke. I was in Japan.
Oh, you have that?
It felt like a karaoke place. Yeah, of course. And I did it there and we were in there for probably too long. And I was standing on a table for a while. singing a song. There was a waiter that came in the room a couple of times, tried to get us out, and then we got him in singing as well. So it went right.
You have to do it big or you don't.
Yeah, absolutely. And what was my song? It was probably something by like AC/DC or something like that.
Yeah.
To my memory, I really enjoyed the big rock stuff.
Nice. What's your biggest fear? Again, we don't have to go too deep.
I'm not great with heights.
Doesn't have to be like dying alone.
I'm not for somebody who flies a lot. I'm not very good with heights.
Okay.
So I don't go on roller coasters. Sorry.
Sorry.
Everybody loves roller coasters. I'm like,
do I look like someone who loves roller coasters?
I'm fine. Everyone's like, let's go, and I'm like, I'm okay.
Like, I'm fine on the ground. It is mad that we do that, to be fair.
I love watching people enjoy it. I'm just I enjoy it more not doing it.
That's nice. You just want to see people have a good time.
I like
that's
the ground.
That's nice.
Yeah.
What's your favourite thing about what you do?
Playing live.
All right.
Like the connection with people, to be honest. Yeah. I mean, and writing new music and creating new music and making a new record and everything is fantastic. But like, to be in one of those little runs where night after night you're playing to new people and the shows are sold out and all this stuff and the crowd are going crazy, that's the greatest thing ever.
What's your least favorite thing about what you do?
Like a 3 a.m. lobby call where you've got to get out of the hotel at like 3 a.m. and you went to bed at like 1.
Gross.
And you really are just falling into that deep sleep, and then the alarm goes off, and you got to go because you got to be in Pennsylvania or something.
Do you ever think you just don't go to sleep?
Yeah, that's fine. There's this great thing in Austin, Texas. Just forgotten what it's called. South by Southwest, which is like this week long music festival, and we had to you played music at loads of crazy hours of the day and night because there's just music happening all the time. So sometimes you're playing a set at like 8 a.m.
Ew.
And sometimes you're starting at like 12:30 in the morning, and then once we finished it, we've been there all week. Once we finished it, it's time to go home. So yeah, we got to go home, but it meant getting back to the hotel for sort of 1:30, getting into bed at like 2, because at 3 a.m. we had to be walking out of the hotel. But we needed that sleep.
So you had that like hour.
That was pretty intense, and I think I fell asleep for 20 minutes.
Oh my god, that makes me feel quite sick.
Yeah, it was like, pretty intense.
Thought of being that tired.
But we were going home. So it wasn't the worst thing in the world. There was literally like 12 hours of flying in front of us because we had to fly from Austin to Chicago, then hang around for a bit, and then Chicago home.
That sucks. That sounds great. For somebody who doesn't really like flying
complain.
That much.
Yeah. Can't complain.
If you weren't a musician, what would you be?
If I wasn't a musician, I would be some sort of painter type person. That's what I was doing at school and everything. That was my kind of big focus, was like painting and drawing and stuff. And then I worked out how to not even do that and just be able to play guitar and get away with it.
If you get rid of all your other skills, it makes that one skill really good.
I hope
so. Is that
so.
How it is?
I hope so. Yeah.
Rid your mind of any other distractions.
Right.
If you could choose to do anything for a day without any consequences, what would it be?
Eat whatever I want.
Oh, that's good.
And just like not, you know, with no consequences.
What
That'd
would
be
it
brilliant.
Be? What would you eat?
All the worst stuff. It's just all the worst stuff. All the most sugary stuff. All the reddest meat. Loads of custard. Not on the meat.
Is there a skill that you would really like to master?
I've never spent much time trying to fly a kite. There's never quite the right kind of wind.
Do you know, actually, that is like a really... Like,
I think it's a skill to
it. It's a skill.
That's literally straight off the top of my head.
You know, it's actually not that fun. Not that I'm like a kite flyer generally, but like, well, I remember doing it when I was younger and I was like, this actually isn't that fun.
But what about if you're on like a big beach and you can run with it and it's all like, you know, get it in slow-mo, like put some music to it. Yeah.
I think I'd just be scared of getting blown away. And finally... If you were ever going to auction off your Brit Award, how much would you want
for it? Oh no, this is like the dude in S Club 7 who did it, poor bloke.
Done it twice.
Oh no.
how much would you want?
I'm just never going to do it. I just
priceless.
I'm just going to hope that I never, what on earth is a Brit Award worth?
We got 66,000 for it, so.
Apparently he needed it.
And also
feel bad for the guy.
It was fake as well.
Oh well.
Gutted.
It's a shame he had to do it.
James Bay, thank you.
No,
like I now
problem.
Know you.
Fantastic.
Yay.